In this lesson, we're going to revisit number stories, and we're going to think about number stories for subtraction. Now, this time I want to bring in an element, and that's another mathematical element, and we're going to really introduce the idea of shape into this as well. So it's, again, number stories, and we talked about how important they are. We're going to look at just how we explore them in terms of subtraction, but also how we can actually get other mathematical elements in there. And we're going to look at shape and space, because again, that's an element at this stage in your child's mathematical journey that they will be talking about and that they will be exploring. So we're going to really focus on shape number stories this time. And again, encouraging your child to develop all that mathematical language, get those shape names, start to think about shape properties, and again, starting to talk about all those aspects of maths. So as we've talked about number stories again before, I'm not going to go into what they are. I'm just going to start with what number stories you might use for subtraction. So for example, I might say to my child this time that I have got 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 what? What shapes are these? And that hopefully your child will tell you squares or rectangles, obviously depending on your drawing and your accuracy. And that is your opportunity to say, oh, squares or rectangles? Well, how do you know? What's the difference between a square and a rectangle? Oh, a square's got all sides that are equal or that are same, and rectangles, they've got different sides. Ah, okay, right. So, okay, so I've got my 5 squares, and these are 5 windows, and there are 5 windows in a house, and a very naughty boy comes along, and he breaks a window. How many windows are going to be left? And this is where you want to encourage your child to actually do that physical crossing out, marking off, taking away. So hopefully your child will then cross one out and say, well, this is the broken window. It's got broken. Look, it's broken. So can you now record that in a number sentence? And again, this is where you're encouraging your child to use those symbols, those numbers, practicing that number formation. And hopefully your child will tell you that there were 5 to begin with. And that's what's slightly different to the addition number stories, where you actually go back to the start for the numeracy or for the subtraction ones, and you have to say, well, what number did you start with? Okay, we started with 5. How many did you take away? How many were broken? 1. And how many have you got left? And we've got 4. Keep focusing on using that range of mathematical vocabulary with your child. The more different types of vocabulary that they're exposed to, the better it will help them when it comes to this sort of problem solving, especially when it comes to the written problem solving later on, as they move through their mathematical journey. And again, I might say, now here are 4 triangles. What's special about a triangle? Oh, a triangle only has 3 sides. And again, you can start that nice mathematical dialogue about shapes and how shapes are different and how do you know different shapes. Well, I'm going to tell you that these are 4 mountains. People are going to go and climb them because mountains are very high. But 1 falls down, has a big landslide, and it disappears. So 1 disappears. How many are going to be left? And again, encouraging your child to actively cross out one of those mountains and then record that number sentence and say, well, there were 4 to begin with. We took away 1, it fell down, and we had 3 left. So again, it's just about really using those number stories in a variety of different situations, in a variety of different contexts. And now, because you have started the addition and the subtraction, you can start to mix them up a bit. So you can start to actually really get your child thinking about the mathematical language by saying something like, right, this time I'm going to have 3 circles. So here's 3 circles. And these 3 circles are 3 little rabbit holes, and a little rabbit lives in there. Now, another rabbit comes along and he digs in another hole. He digs 1 more hole. How many holes do we have now for the rabbits? And hopefully your child is picking out that vocabulary more. How many now do we have all together? Another. All those key words that tells them that they actually have to add, because at this stage you will be saying to your child, what are you going to do? Are you going to cross one out and take it away? Or are you going to add 1 more? And hopefully your child will pick up on that language and say, I'm going to add 1 more. And if they don't, that's fine. You just need to encourage them and allow them that time to actually begin to understand and actually point out that vocabulary, point out the fact that, well, what does more mean? Remember we looked at it when we had a pile that had more? What did that actually mean? Oh, it was bigger, it got bigger. Well, what happens if we add another rabbit hole? How many do we have now? Oh, we have four. Is that a bigger number? Am I adding? Am I taking away? How do I make a bigger number? So you want to have that discussion with your child. So hopefully your child will know that more means adding and they'll draw their little rabbit hole and then you can say, oh, what symbol are you going to use now? You could use adding or you could use taking away or subtraction. What are you going to use? And allow them to actually really explore that and start to see that difference between addition and subtraction and the difference between what happens to those numbers, that with subtraction the numbers get smaller, with addition the numbers get bigger. And you want to be continually pointing that out to your child so that they can actually start to use those clues themselves when they're actually actively problem solving. But again, problems that can be actually mixed up, can be used, and can be actually done anywhere, any place, and really something that you can be using on a daily basis.